Hey guys, Antonio here with some more Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman. Today we're going to talk about chapter 11, which is anchors. And it's all about this thing called the anchoring effect. And it's basically when people consider a particular value for an unknown quantity before estimating that quantity. So let me give you an example. If I asked you, how old do you think I am? Over 54 or lower than 54? I'm sure right now you're starting to think based off of a number that I gave you, which was 54. You're starting to think, is it possible that he's older than 54? No. But it makes you think about it, right? I mean, I don't think I look over 54. Some people might think that, but that's basically what happens, is it starts to make you think based off of the information you got. And again, this goes back to your associative mind. You see the little fact that you have, which is 54. So your mind takes that as a piece of information, a piece of evidence to solve the puzzle. And that's where the anchoring effect comes into play. It might pull you to think that maybe I'm 40 or high 30s, when in reality I'm in my 20s. But if I had given you, if I told you, do you think I'm older than or less than 17, you might say I'm older, but you might think I'm a lot younger than I was. So the point here is the anchoring effect might not get you to get the wrong answer, but it'll pull you and your idea towards the information given in the direction it likes you to. So you have to watch out when someone gives you information. If you take a huge example of this, which is sales that happens in clothing stores and electronic stores and stuff like that. If someone tells you that the price was $100 originally, but it's on sale for $25, you're gonna think, wow, this is a steal. Because you're going off of the anchoring effect that it was 100, and 25 is so much different than that. But if the sale was started at $33 and now it's 25, the price is the same. It's still gonna cost you $25. What ends up happening is you don't think that the sale is as big and you might not buy it as much. So if companies then mark up what they have and then just have sales all the time, it will cause people to buy those things a lot more, because you'll start thinking, wow, this is a huge discount on an expensive item, making you think that the quality is a lot higher because it's more expensive, and at the same time making you want to buy it because it's only for a limited time that it's on this sale. So think about that when someone is trying to sell you something, if they give you discounts and stuff like that. The anchoring effect might pull you towards a certain thing. This also comes in negotiation. Let's say you're trying to buy a house, and the first person starts off with an offer for $100,000 for the house. The person who responds bases his offer off of $100,000. Unless if the offer is so ridiculously far that you reject it automatically, normally let's say your starting offer was $150,000, you might be like, okay, I'll do it for $120,000. You know, because someone lowered the bar, causing the anchoring effect to happen, it made you think that the house was less in value. So you need to watch out for that anchoring effect, because it can really play with you. They give advice on how to go about these negotiations and sales, and basically walk away from the situation when you hear that number, and try to come up with the number that you think it's worth in your own time. That's the only way you're going to be able to not be affected by the anchoring effect. If you enjoyed this book so far, I left the link in the description down low for you to purchase a copy of it yourself and follow along. There's a lot of great information here. If you like this video specifically on the anchoring effect, please give it a thumbs up. I'd much appreciate it. And share with your friends on social media who might be affected by this anchoring effect, because I know I am, and a lot of you are too, probably. Leave a comment in this down low if you'd like for me to do any future books, or any comments you have on this video, or any opinions on your anchoring effect. Also, subscribe for more videos of me talking about the books that I'm reading, giving you guys a lot of information. All right, guys, have a great day.